everybody. Thank you for coming out to see the middle school variety show. I hope you enjoyed the show. I'm going to leave it to the eighth graders, and we're going to MC tonight's show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 2018 Middle School Variety Show.
We are your amazing hosts, Ian,
Bella,
Brooke,
and Ellie. We have 28 amazing acts for you to see tonight.
Our first act is the passion project of one of our fellow eighth graders.
She worked very hard to create the first ever middle school a cappella group, Pending. Here's to sing the greatest show from the greatest showman. Please welcome Pending.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you waited for.
Whoa!
In searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor.
Whoa!
You can't ignore, taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that is real is left behind.
Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what comes after. You'll feel the dreams, can't you see it getting closer? Just surrender because you feel the feeling taking over.
It's fire, it's freedom,
it's wide and open.
It's a picture in the coffin, and you find a virtual world.
Breaking at the brink of every wall, told me all that you know.
So tell me, do you wanna go?
Where it's covered in all the colored lights. Where the grind away to run in the night. Impossible comes true, it's taking over you. Oh, this is the greatest show. We light it up, we won't come down. And the sun can't stop us now. Watching it come true, it's taking over you. Oh, this is the greatest show.
have a good evening.
They announced that the iPhone 10 is out. So first they announced the iPhone 8, and then 5 minutes later they announced the iPhone 10. So first of all, if anyone has an iPhone, just throw that away. Just while you're exiting the building, just find an empty trash can. Okay, so they announced the iPhone 8, then 5 minutes later they announced the iPhone 10. So I bet you're wondering, well, what happened to iPhone 9? Well, I've done some pretty clear research, and it's pretty clear that their kindergarten did not teach them how to count to 9. I really feel bad for them, because I mean, they know how to do some robotics and they know how to engineer, but they just don't know how to count to 9. I need to find a lawyer to sue that school. Yeah. So this is the iPhone 10, and they sell it for at least $1,000. The X stands for expensive. Very, very expensive. This is one of the big changes right here. Not only the front is glass, but so is the back. So now you can break both sides. It's for the people that break their front and think, I can do better. That's actually a good thing now, because now you can charge your phone without even plugging it in. So I think you put it on a hot plate? Hot plate. Yeah. And then you put it as hot as it goes, and I think that charges faster. Hot plates are gonna sell it like hot plates, guys. Just get sell out. They also make the screen bigger. It's 5.8 inches, 4.8 when it's cold. And they also made a new way to unlock your phone. You just look at it and then it just unlocks. It's called face recognition. This technology is so advanced that you only have to swipe your face, scan your face once, and then after you get a haircut, after you get a nose job, and then after you get some glasses, and then after you lose that 15 pounds you've been wanting to lose, and then after you gain that 15 pounds back. And I think I said enough to Apple, so thank you.
Now we have 2 7th graders forming a comedic duo from the Broadway show, The Little Mermaid. Enjoy.
So, here's the deal. I will make you a potion that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Got that? 3 days. Now listen, this is important. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to fall in love with you. That is, he's got to kiss you.
He's got to what?
Kiss you.
Kiss me.
That's how love works, sweetheart.
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean he's fallen in love with me.
Well, I know that, Ariel, but it's not just any kiss. It's the kiss of true love.
Can I go get him now?
What? No! No gross. It's just... a nice, soft, true love peck, like your mom gives you before bedtime, except a little longer because it's for a boy and it's true love.
Ursula, people kiss each other all the time. It doesn't necessarily mean you're in love.
Okay, that's ridiculous. Why would anybody do that? Their mouths are touching.
You're an evil temptress, and you don't know how kissing works.
Okay, well, it just means these creepy seaweed people around here all day, so I'm a little out of practice.
Have you ever kissed a real person?
Uh-huh.
How old are you?
Okay, well, as shocking as this may be, you don't get a lot of bright sweats when you're a plus-size half octopus. Maybe if I were a centaur.
Ursula, do you have any friends? Do you get out at all?
This is about me, okay? You want to be a human, don't you?
Yes.
Are you in or not?
I just think it's unrealistic to expect 2 people to fall in love in 3 days.
You have your looks, your pretty face, and don't underestimate the importance of body language.
Okay, what was that? What do you mean by body language?
It's, you know.
No, I know. You know.
Yes? So, since we both know, I don't have to get into it.
Humor me.
Well, it's her, and then it's, and you just too, and I've got who's it and what's it galore. You want to think of thoughts? I got 20. Get out! And leave your voice in the shell by the door. Thank you.
Now we have a fun dance for you to see. These four girls will sure light it up.
The song Lost Boy.
There was a time when I was alone, nowhere to go and no place to call home. My only friend was the man in the moon, and even sometimes he would go away too. Then one night I closed my eyes, I saw a shadow flying high. He came to me with the sweetest smile, told me he wanted to talk for a while. He said, Peter Pan, that's what they call me. I promise that you'll never be lonely, and ever since that day I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored, we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Run, run, lost boy, they say to me. Away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. He sprinkled me in pixie dust and told me to believe in him and believe in me. Together we will fly away in a cloud of green to your beautiful destiny. As we soared above a town that never loved me, I realized I finally had a family. Soon enough we'll reach Neverland. Peacefully my feet hit the sand, and never since that day I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. And when we're bored we play in the woods, always on the run from Captain Hook. Gone, wrong, lost boy, they say to me, away from all of reality. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free. Neverland is home to lost boys like me, and lost boys like me are free.
Excellent for this small group musical at Districts. Here is When I Grow Up.
Thank you.
car. Please welcome Ava.
Oh, time, Kimmy and Kelly from Chicken Bones to the Teenage Soup.
And we proudly represent Troop 88197.
Kelly!
Hi! Hi, Kimmy.
Kelly, you're my very best friend. You're amazing.
Kimmy, you know I feel the same way about you.
I will always love you. I mean it. You know, Bridget gave me one of her school photos yesterday. One of the little wallet-sized ones. And she wrote on the back of it, best friends forever. But she doesn't really mean that. She was just writing that.
She wrote that on mine, too.
No way.
No way.
See, that's what I mean. Some friends go around writing that stuff and saying that stuff to everybody. But when I give it to you, and when I write it on the back of my 8x10 school photo I give you, you know, I really mean it. Kimmy and Kelly, best friends always.
Forever.
And ever. See, that shows what amazing friends we are when we finish
each other's sentences.
Yeah, we're like one person.
Inside two bodies.
Sometimes when I'm talking to you, I feel like I'm just talking to myself.
Yeah, and how many times have we worn practically the exact same thing to school and we didn't even call each other?
Destiny.
True, true friendship. We are going to the same college, aren't we?
You better believe it. And we'll both major in psychology.
And we'll graduate together and become famous psychologists.
And we'll have offices next door to each other. We'll call ourselves Kimmy and Kelly Best Friend Psychology.
I love that. That's perfect.
You're perfect, Kelly.
So are you, Kimmy.
We have the same taste in music, the same taste in food.
Same taste in fashion.
And the same taste in guys.
We do, don't we?
Which reminds me, you know what, Kelly?
What?
If I ever catch you flirting with Marco again, none of this will be crap.
What?
You know what I'm talking about.
Okay, fine, fine. Anyone was flirting with anyone, he was flirting with me. Can I help it if he just finds me attractive?
Why would he find a fat cow attractive? I have no idea.
Maybe it's because he's stuck with a bloated, self-centered witch.
Me? Self-centered? Look, he's talking a little bit strongly.
Look in the mirror. You make me sick.
Stay away from Marco.
Make me.
I hate you.
Not as much as I hate you. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Colin Mann. Today I'll be performing Ring of Keys from the musical Fun Home, and I proudly represent Troop 88197. I don't.
is Keen, and today I will be performing the role of Rodolfo from A View from the Bridge by Arthur Miller, and I proudly represent Troop 88197. What do you mean you want to live in Italy? Italy? You're fooling. I don't understand why I want to get married and live in Italy. You want to be an Italian? Kathleen, if I ever got you home with no money, no business, nothing, they would call the priest and the doctor, and they would say, Ricardo is crazy. You can't be happy there. What would you eat? Can you cook with you? There's nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Now, tell me what you are talking about. How can I bring you from a rich country to suffer in a poor country? What are you talking about? I would be a criminal, stealing your face. In 2 years, you would have an old, hungry face. When my brother's babies cry, they give them water. Water to boil the bone, don't you believe that? We wouldn't live here with Eddie. Once I'm a citizen, I could work anywhere and I would find better jobs. And we could have a housekeeping. If I were not afraid to be arrested, I would start to do something wonderful here. Go there with nothing. No. I will not marry you to live in Italy. I want you to be my wife and I want to be a citizen. Tell him that or I will. And tell him also, and tell yourself please, that I am not a beggar. And you are not a horse, a gift and favor for a poor immigrant. I am furious. You think I am so desperate? My brother is desperate, not me. You think I would carry on my back the rest of my life a woman I didn't love just to be an American? It's so wonderful. You think we have no tall buildings in Italy, no white streets, no flags, no automobiles? Only work we don't have. I want to be an American so I can work. That is the only wonder here. But how can you insult me, Kathleen? My heart dies to look at you. Why are you so afraid of him? Thank you.
Hello, I'm Stella, and I will be performing Look What Happened to Mabel from the musical Mac and Mabel, and I proudly represent Troop 88197.
Pretty special. Representative Troop 88197.
Dearest darlingest Mumsy and Popsicle, my dear father, there's been some confusion, all the room is near ashes, but of course I'll care for Nessa,
of course I'll rise above it,
for I know that's how you want me to respond.
Yes,
there's been some confusion, for you see my roommate is
unusually and exceedingly peculiar, altogether quite impossible to describe.
Ugh, blonde.
What is this feeling so sudden and new?
Of the moments I laid under you.
My pulse is rushing, my head is reeling, my face is flushing.
What is this feeling burning and flame? Does it have a name? Yes. Loathing. I'm adulterated loathing.
For your face.
Your voice.
Loathing.
Let's just say, I love it all. Every little trait, however small, makes my very flesh begin to crawl. Simple, utter loathing. There's a strange exhilaration in such total detestation. It's a pure surprise. Though I do admit it came on fast, still I do believe that it can last. And I
thank you. Maybe it's all 'cause little dad, his new kid, it's his new wife. disobey me.
Don't even think about going to that audition.
Please!
No!
Mother!
Stop!
Stop telling me what to do!
Don't!
Don't treat me like a child of two!
No!
I know that you want what's best!
Please!
But Mother, please, give it a rest!
Stop! Go! No!
Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Zayfield, here I am. I'm the greatest star. I am by far. No one knows it. That's why I'm far. I'll blow my heart till someone
from the musical Miss Saigon, and I proudly represent Troop 88197. Why does Saigon never sleep at night? Why does the skirts of orange trees? How can I feel good when nothing's right? Why'd she want me? There is no breeze, green man. You don't give answers, do you, friend? Just questions that don't ever end. Why, God? Why today? I'm on through here, on my way. There's nothing left here that I'll miss. Why send me?
Calvin Berger.
And we proudly represent Troop 88197.
You have to bid on him.
You're nuts.
Why not?
What if I win and he's not into me? Think how humiliating that would be. He's the closest friend I have by far. It's safer just to leave things how they are. It's not to mention there's that other fact. I don't exactly look like you.
Thank you.
love you. I love how she performs this piece. Please enjoy.
Theater career.